In Bihar, the marathon process of assembly polls comes to an end today as the campaigning for the fifth and the final phase of elections will end at 5 p.m. 57 constituencies spread over 9 districts including Darbhanga, Madhubani, Saharsa, Supaul, Madhepur, Purnia, Araria, Kishanganj and Katihar will go to polls on Thursday. All parties have left no stone unturned to woo voters. Underworld Don Chota Rajan may be deported to India in the next 2 to 3 days. Reacting on Rajan's deportation, Indian Ambassador to Indonesia, Gurjeet Singh said that a team of India is taking up the entire matter and the process is on. A police team from India interrogated him in Bali on Monday. During the questioning, Chota Rajan said that Daud Ibrahim is in Pakistan and Pakistani intelligence agency ISI is hiding him. Addressing a joint press conference with Indonesian Vice President Yusuf Kala in the Indonesian capital, Vice President Hamid Ansari said that India and Indonesia are both committed to increasing bilateral trade and mutual investments, as well as expanding cooperation in defence and counter-terrorism. Vice President, who is on a 5-day visit to Indonesia, also said that both nations were on the same page on several issues. Emir of Qatar, Sheikh Tamim bin Hamad Al Thani, called up Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Monday and invited him to pay a visit there while expressing interest in partnering India's economic growth. Prime Minister Modi accepted the invitation to visit Qatar at a mutually convenient date. During the telephonic conversation, the two leaders also discussed measures to further deepen bilateral cooperation. Prime Minister Narendra Modi has expressed shock and condemned the killing of a youngster from Bihar due to police firing in the Indo-Nepal border on Monday. Earlier, External Affairs Ministry spokesperson Vikas Swarup said that causes underlying the current state of confrontation need to be addressed by the government of Nepal credibly and effectively. According to official reports, the 40-day-old agitation has claimed over 40 lives and injured nearly 800 people. Seeking to make the collegium system more participatory, the government is likely to suggest to the Supreme Court today the constitution of a committee of eminent persons which would scrutinize candidates for appointment to the higher judiciary before the collegium takes the final call. The Supreme Court collegium decides on the appointment of High Court judges, their transfer and promotion as Chief Justice of a High Court and their elevation to the Apex Court. The Supreme Court on Monday took note of a PIL alleging improper implementation of MNREGA in terms of timely payment of wages and compensation and asked the government to make payments promptly. The Apex Court said that the states should wake up and make prompt payments while issuing notice to the Ministry of Rural Development. The Apex Court was hearing a plea by RTI activist Aruna Roy and others. The Uber cab driver who was held guilty of raping a woman passenger in his taxi and trying to strangulate her while committing the act last year is likely to be sentenced today by a Delhi court. He was convicted by court on October 20th. In Jammu and Kashmir, two army soldiers were killed in firing by Pakistani soldiers in Gurez sector in Bandipora district on Monday. An army spokesperson said that the soldiers were killed when Pakistani army resorted to unprovoked firing that hit a post in the area. The army retaliated in a befitting manner. The firing started late afternoon. Officials said this act was aimed at facilitating the infiltration along the LOC. The Maharashtra government has decided to lift the storage limit it had imposed on imported pulses, cooking oil and oil seeds to keep a check on the spiraling prices of food grains. Restrictions on storage of pulses had been imposed by the state government on October 19th, following directions of the centre. These restrictions included imported food grains as well. Since 1977, there has been no limit set on stocking of pulses. The price of non-subsidised cooking gas LPG has gone up by 27 rupees 50 paise a cylinder. Now, 14.2 kg cylinder in Delhi will cost 545 rupees. In Kolkata, it will cost 575 rupees per cylinder, in Mumbai 555 rupees and in Chennai the price will be 559.5 rupees a cylinder. The non-subsidized LPG price was last cut on 1st of October by 42 rupees per cylinder. Pakistan has banned media coverage of Mumbai attack mastermind Hafiz Saeed led Jamaat-ud-Dawah as part of a crackdown on terrorism. The Pakistan Electronic Media Regulatory Authority issued a notification to all satellite TV channels and radio stations banning the coverage of Lashkar-e-Taiba, Jamaat-ud-Dawah and Falah-e-Insaniyat Foundation under United Nations restrictions. For the first time, a Pakistan government department has admitted that the Jamaat-ud-Dawah and Falah-e-Insaniyat are other wings of Lashkar-e-Taiba. The UN Refugee Agency has said that more than 2,18,000 migrants crossed the Mediterranean in October this year. a record monthly tally this year and more than in all of 2014. Meanwhile, thousands of migrants gathered at the border between Slovenia and Austria, many having waited hours to cross without food or water. On Monday, NASA marked 15 years of humans living on board the International Space Station. The station has been occupied continuously by humans since it became operational over a decade ago, a feat that astronauts said could shape travel within the solar system. India's top singles player Yuki Bhamri regained his place in the top 100 as he jumped 16 places to touch a career best rank of 89. It now ensures him a direct entry into the main draw of the Australian Open. Saket Mayaneni remained unchanged at 168, while Somdev Devarman gained a place to be at 180.